Hello everyone, I am Bob and this is the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining channel. In this episode, I'm going to show you my new BCB100 miner control board, including installation, setup, and my first impressions. So with that, let's get started. And before we get started, I want to take a minute to announce the latest sponsor of the channel, and that is BRAIINS. BRAIINS has been a great innovator in the mining space, including forming one of the very first mining pools, the development of custom mining firmware, and most recently getting into the hardware side of mining with their BCB100 control board and their upcoming PSU. Last summer, I met the BRAIINS crew at the Bitcoin 2023 conference, where I got my first look at the BCB100 control board and got to chat about future episodes of the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining channel. After watching a few episodes, the BRAIINS team approached me and offered to support the channel. I was already using the BRAIINS mining pool, and I couldn't have been happier to bring them on as a sponsor. And so, in upcoming episodes, in addition to covering fantastic Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining topics, I'll be covering different parts of the BRAIINS full-stack mining infrastructure, giving you an overview of everything BRAIINS has to offer. And so with that, on with the episode. Okay, I've been mining for a while now with my stock S10 miners, and everything is working pretty well. My miners are hashing away, and my immersion system is working just fine, heating my house and heating my hot water. And so the first big question to ask is why would I want to swap out a critical part of my setup by switching out the control boards on my miners? And the answer to that question has to do with how Bitmain miners are manufactured and how they operate. Bitmain makes thousands of miners every year. Each of these miners have 3 hashboards, and each hashboard has 126 ASIC chips. This means they are cranking out millions of chips each year, and with that many chips, there's going to be some variability in manufacturing. Some chips are more efficient at converting electrical power to hashing calculations, and some chips are less efficient. Now, in a given miner, all of the chips on the 3 hashboards are controlled by a single control board on the top of the miner. And this control board has software called firmware, which controls the speeds of all the chips on all 3 boards. Now, Bitmain keeps this stock firmware very simple. It runs all the chips on the boards at the same speed. In addition, Bitmain sets that speed so that the slowest, worst performing chip made across all of its miners won't burn out. Now, the odds of any specific miner having that worst performing chip is pretty low. Most miners are going to have all of their chips capable of running faster than stock speeds, and subminers will have chips capable of running a lot faster than stock speeds. In addition, chip efficiency is related to speed. Running a high-performance chip at lower speed will result in more efficient energy use, and running a low-performance chip at higher speeds will result in less efficient energy use. And so what all of this means is that when miners are run with the stock firmware, they are going to run safely, but that safe operation comes with missing out on a ton of unused hash power and efficiency gains. If each chip was run at its optimal speed, with bad chips running slower and good chips running faster, the entire miner could generate more hash power with more efficient power usage. And this is why installing custom firmware on a miner can be a fantastic improvement for a mining setup. Lucky for us, external vendors such as BRAIINS have developed just this type of custom firmware that is designed to optimize miner operation. And so the next question to ask is how to get this custom firmware onto a miner. Now, there are methods of uploading custom firmware to SD drives and then loading that to the stock control board, but that can be a bit of a pain, and it only works for certain types of older control boards. And this is where the BRAIINS BCB100 control board makes updating your firmware super easy. The BCB100 comes loaded with the BRAIINS OS Plus custom firmware. You just swap the board, turn on the miner, and you're ready to go. The board is currently compatible with these miners, and the BRAIINS team is adding new miner models to this list as fast as they can. And to show you how easy it is to add the BRAIINS BCB100 to your miner, I'm going to walk through swapping out the board. And the first step is to shut down my miners and pumps and open up my DCX Bitpod tank. After that, internet and power cables are disconnected. And the miner can be pulled from the tank. As you can see, I'm using a plastic top from a storage bin to catch the fluid draining off the miner. Now, I covered how to remove the top two covers from an S19 miner in a past episode. It's very quick and easy, and you can catch the link above if you want to see more detail. And with the miner sitting upright, the first step is to remove the three ribbon cables from the back of the control board. Remove the power connector. And remove the PSU control connector. Next, remove the two screws holding on the front plate and remove the plate. The stock control board then simply slides out. Now, the BCB100 comes in this really cool looking box. Inside, you'll find the board in an anti-static bagging, a keychain, and a small card with a QR code to the BRAIINS Help Telegram group. If you have any problems with the board install or setup, this is a fantastic resource for getting a hand. And in the bottom of the box, you'll see another QR code for the device manual, which is another great resource. After removing the board from the anti-static bag, the new BRAIINS BCB100 board slides back into the same place as the stock board. Reversing the steps, the front plate goes back on. The same two screws hold the board in place. And reconnecting all the cables completes the install. The miner gets set back into the tank. Cables are reconnected. And the pumps and mining power are turned back on. Now, before setting up the firmware and getting the miners hashing again, you'll have to sign up with a mining pool. Now, I covered mining pool selection in a previous episode, but when you use custom firmware, there's a new wrinkle to the mining fees you have to pay. When you use custom firmware, the firmware developer almost always takes a small cut from your mining profits. This is called a developer fee or dev fee, and this is usually a few percent of your mined Bitcoin. This means you now have to pay both a pool fee and a dev fee, which together can really eat into your mining profits. And BRAIINS is no different here. To use their firmware, they charge a 2.5% dev fee. However, if you use the BRAIINS OS Plus firmware along with the BRAIINS mining pool, they will waive their pool fee. This means with BRAIINS, you can mine with custom firmware, optimizing your mining without paying excessive fees. Now, to sign up to the BRAIINS pool, it's really straightforward. Go to the website, click sign up, give an email address, username, and password, and you'll be sent a confirmation email. Once your email address is confirmed, you can log on and see your dashboard. Now, when you start out, things are blank, and so the first step is to add miners, or what the BRAIINS website calls workers. Click on the workers tab, and once you are there, you'll want to click on Stratum V2 to get your pool address. This will be used later when you set up the pool on each miner. Now, there are a bunch of other things you can do here, such as configure your mining payout, but you can do that later after you've started mining. With the BRAIINS pool ready and waiting for your miners, the next step is to get your miners hashing with the new BCB100 control boards. But before getting into that, I just want to ask you to hit that subscribe button below if you haven't already, and to hit that like button. This will tell that all-powerful YouTube algorithm that this is good stuff and will help get these videos out to more people like you. And the first step in setting up the new control board is to find the miner on your network. I like to use the Angry IP scanner. It's a free tool and easy to use. Open the tool, start your scan, and once it is done, sort your results by ping. And in this software, you're looking for an IP address with a green dot using only port 80 and without an existing host name. Copy that IP address into a browser and you should get sent to the BCB100 login screen. The initial username and password is root and root, and when you first log in, the miner won't be mining. And the first step to set up the miner is to reset the miner password and set the miner hostname. Go to System, and then scroll down and enter a new password, and below that is the miner hostname. You want to change that as well. Next, you want to go to the Configuration tab, and this is where you'll be entering the mining information you got from the BRAIINS Pool website. And you want to make sure the username you enter here matches the user ID from that website. Now, since this is an immersion setup, the BRAIINS OS Plus firmware must be configured to run with the miner without being connected to fans. And the BRAIINS OS Plus firmware makes this really easy. Just click the Temperature and Fans menu and check the Enable Immersion Mode box. With the miner configured, the final step is to restart the miner firmware by clicking Quick Actions and then Restart BOS Miner. If you entered everything correctly, the miner will restart, and in 5 or so minutes, you'll be mining. Now, during this setup process, you will likely see a warning that says something along the lines of, you have no connection to licensing server. Just ignore it. That warning will go away after everything is connected and the miner is running. Now, after you get the miners up and running, there are a ton of other capabilities and features on the BRAIINS OS Plus firmware to optimize and control your miner operation, and I'll be covering these in future episodes. But for now, I just want to give you my first impressions. And the bottom line is I think getting a BCB100 control board for your home Bitcoin immersion mining setup is a no-brainer. These boards currently cost only about $100, and when using the BCB100 in an immersion mining setup, you don't need to add fan spoofers to your miner. The BRAIINS OS Plus firmware can simply turn fan control off. Now, a full set of fan spoofers for a single miner are about $40. So really, if you get a BCB100 board, the effective net cost is only $60. And when you take into account the increases in profit from chip optimization and overclocking, that $60 goes away fairly quickly. Also, there are other really cool capabilities in the BRAIINS OS Plus firmware, such as dynamic performance scaling, which will help optimize the heat output for home heating usage. And along the way, if you have problems in setting up the board or questions about board operation, the BRAIINS Help Telegram channel is super responsive and they get back to you right away. Overall, looking at all the benefits you get with the BCB100 control board, you can run without it, but this is something you really should get if you want a great home Bitcoin immersion mining setup. It's really that cool. Now, one last quick topic to cover is miner warranty. Bitmain makes it very clear that running with any firmware other than what they provide will totally void all warranties on the miner. If you are air cooling your miner, this may be something to think about. But with an immersion setup, the warranty was already voided when the fans were removed and the miner was dunked. So adding custom firmware here really doesn't change that much. The warranty is still voided. If you break your miner, you're still on your own. Okay, so that's all I have for this episode. In the next episode, I'm going to be covering my Bitcoin garage heater and more of the awesome capabilities of the BRAIINS OS Plus firmware. Like, subscribe so you don't miss any new episodes coming your way. And with that, bye.